We're gonna dive real deep back into a lot of stuff as we go, but again, we're just gonna hit the high notes, get real comfortable in some of these positions, and then we're gonna come back. Now, high crotch position, I kind of break down into three different levels, okay? So if I can get this guy all the way stretched out, two knees on the mat, hips engaged, kind of sprawled out, or if my knees are still bent, I consider this kind of level one, okay? Level two, I got him kind of stretched out, my drive leg knee, or his drive leg knee is not on the mat, all right? He's still kind of up and has a chance to build, but I've got a little bit of a sprawl. I've got space from his elbows to his ribs. This is important, okay? Level three, I really don't have a lot of options here. His head's up, hips in, back straight, right? And I'm trying to get the leg back. Now, we're gonna start level three just because this is a good mobile drill, all right? Frank Chamizo's a wizard here, all right? He has amazing hips, and he attacks with his hips. And by attacks with his hips, I mean he uses his hips to run into guys. Most of you guys have been training your whole life, take your hips away, take your legs away. Now, this is what I want you to think about. This baseline defense sprawl, if I take my hips and my legs away, my head's gonna drop every single time. If I develop a habit of dropping my head when this guy's in on a leg attack, that's draping. When I drape, and this isn't scramble technique, this is baseline defense technique. Anytime my head drops, my feet get light. Anytime my feet get light, this guy smiles on the inside, okay? So as my legs go back, my hips go in. Does everybody see that? This is a weird thing for your body to concept because you always have been taught a lot of times hips and legs go back so head drops, all right? But I want you guys to focus on anytime you're sprawling, moving forward, hips are in, legs are back, okay? I'm putting a ton of tension on his grip. Now, in this particular instance, we're not gonna fight our hips back near as much. We're gonna drop our hips down, which is gonna accomplish something similar because it's gonna sag on his lock, all right? I'm gonna pop his shoulder and I'm gonna replace it with my far side elbow. I'm gonna step outside, I'm gonna pop his shoulder and I'm gonna replace it with my elbow, all right? See how his shoulder shifted outside of my hip. Anytime he's in on a high crotch, his shoulder being in the pocket right here is important, whether I'm on my feet or in a crack down, any of those positions. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna step and pop and dig our elbow right here in the crease of his armpit, all right? We're gonna pop, dig, and squat. See how I'm in a good athletic position? I'm not bent over, I'm in an athletic position right here. And then all I want you to do is kind of drive into this guy. Don't do anything else. And then we'll start talking about our re-attack. So he shoots this high crotch, I'm gonna pop the shoulder and beat it. Pop the shoulder as I step and dig. Everybody see this position right here? Elbows tight in the armpit, and then I'm just driving into him a little bit. Butt stays low, chest stays up, all right? So I'm stepping, popping, digging. Right here. That's my motion, and then I'm just driving in, tight elbow. Go, you did it.